If you want to learn the best high-quality export and render settings for your YouTube videos, then you've come to the right place. I'm Pete from the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we have videos explaining everything you need to do to grow your passion into your profession. And today I'm going to be talking through the best render and export settings for Vegas 14. Before I get started, I just wanted to mention that the software I'll be using for this tutorial is Vegas Pro 14. It doesn't really matter if you're using an older version of Sony Vegas though, because the render settings haven't changed that much. If, however, you're looking for render settings for Adobe Premiere Pro, I've got another video that I'll link up here in the top corner. So check that out if that's the software you're using. That being said, let's get into it. So here you can see we're in Vegas Pro 14, and I've got some test footage down here, which is basically some Overwatch gameplay. Some commentary over the top and an intro and an outro, but the kind of thing that I imagine you guys are going to be rendering out of Vegas. So first thing you want to make sure is that you have the full timeline selected of everything that you want to render. Then you go up to File and then down to Render As, and it'll open up this new box. So the first thing you want to do is select the right output format. We're looking for main concept AVC/AAC, this one here. So if you click the little down arrow next to that, it's going to give you a lot of different templates, really. It doesn't really matter which one you choose because we're going to be editing it anyway, but we might as well start with something quite close. So if we select this Internet HD 1080p and then click Customize Template, this is going to open up some more advanced settings, which we're going to play with now. You want to make sure the include video is checkmarked, obviously, otherwise you're going to get a black video, which won't be very good for your YouTube audience. Frame size, this is the actual size of your footage. So hopefully you've been recording in 1920 by 1080, as that really is the standard now for YouTube gaming videos. Obviously, if you have a hardware limitation and you've had to record at something like 720p, you can change it here if that's what your source footage was. You really want to be rendering out your video in the same resolution as the source footage was recorded, but hopefully you've got something recorded in 1920 by 1080. Make sure that this box is unchecked because you don't want the source to adjust the frame size at all. On profile, you want to select high. Now frame rate, again, this is kind of similar to resolution. You want to be choosing the same frame rate that you are recording your actual source footage at. Mine's recorded at 60, but sometimes you might not have the option for 60, but you can just type it in anyway. So I'm just going to delete that, type in 60, as that is what I want to be rendering at. I really do recommend as well now that you upload your footage at 60 FPS and 1080p, as YouTube does support it, and it gives you a slightly higher bit rate for 60 FPS, so it does look better, and especially for first-person shooter games, it's going to look a lot more fluid. But obviously, again, if you have hardware limitations and you had to record at 30, then set your frame rate here to 30. Again, untick this, allow source to adjust frame rate. You want to make sure your field order is left here at non-progressive scan and your pixel aspect ratio is set to 1, otherwise it's going to look really strange and stretched. Now, number of reference frames. I've seen some people recommend upping this, but I haven't noticed any difference. If you really do feel paranoid about your quality, you could change this to 14 and tick used a blocking filter, but I haven't noticed any difference at all, so I've left it at 2 here. Bitrate settings. Now, this is where you need to concentrate a bit more. Firstly, you want to select 2-pass, and I'll just explain why. If you use a 2-pass system, the first pass is just analyzing your project, and the second pass actually executes the compression. So 2-pass does yield a better result, especially for gaming video where there's a lot of high motion. It will really benefit from the second pass. But you must note that it does take significantly longer than if you just use a 1-pass system. So if you want the best quality, you want to tick 2-pass here. Now, maximum and average bit rates. I see a lot of videos on YouTube recommending people put in 50 million here on a target bit rate, and it really does surprise me because YouTube compresses the shit out of every video that you upload. So once you go past a certain amount, you aren't going to be able to see any difference in quality as YouTube will compress it anyway. Save yourself some time. I've done the testing. Let's set these to 16 for the maximum, 16 million, and 14 for the average. Any higher than that, you're going to get such negligible differences in quality, and it's going to really increase your render time. So the people that are recommending doing 50 or 100 here are just honestly wasting so much time and processing power. Number of slices can be left at default on 4. Now you might have an option here for encode mode, which allows you to, if you have an Nvidia graphics card, you'll be able to use some special technology to increase your render time and offload some of that task to the video card. I've had quite a lot of issues with previous versions of Sony Vegas and this version of Vegas Pro, so I've actually disabled it completely. But if you're going to be rendering out a lot of different videos, which I hope you are for your YouTube channel, and you don't have any issues by selecting one of the technologies here, such as CUDA, then I do recommend using it, as it will cut down in your render time. But if you are having any issues, make sure you just select the CPU only for your render method. Enable progressive download, you want to keep that ticked, and then we'll go across to the audio tab. Obviously, again, make sure you're including your audio, otherwise you'll have a video with no audio. You want to leave sample rate at 48,000, and bit rate for the audio, I wouldn't recommend going any lower than 192, just because it will start to sound a bit shit. So I actually do go up to 320, but that's probably unnecessary. Anything between 192 and 320 is absolutely fine. System doesn't have anything that we can edit anyway. And then finally on project, there's only one setting we need to change, which is video rendering quality. We want to up that to best. Now, we don't want to have to do this every single time we render a video, so we can actually save this as a template. I'm going to call mine YouTube best quality 1080p 60fps. Click the little save icon, and then I can now select that every time I want to render. So we press OK. You'll see here our newly created template. I recommend clicking the little star there, because then you can find it easily when you're rendering each time. Last thing to do is to browse and name our project. So if you want to save it wherever you want, I'm just going to save this in my documents under the name test project. Click save. Render loop region only. This is if you have your region selected. I'm going to render the whole project anyway, as it's the same as my loop region, so I can uncheck that. Last thing to do is to click render, and your render should start. And that is it. Once your render has finished, upload it to YouTube, enter in your description, your titles, your tags, all that good stuff, upload your custom thumbnail, and then prepare for the sudden influx of comments of people telling you how great your new video looks. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found the video helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, because that really helps us get to know which kind of content you guys enjoy and we can make more of it in the future. Also, if you're new here at the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, be sure to have a look around. We've got loads of tutorials helping you grow your passion into your profession, really up your numbers on YouTube and on Twitch. So if that's something that interests you, be sure to click subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.